Welcome to Sesame Street.
Oh, hey, welcome to Sesame Street.
Hey.
Hiya, Telly.
Oh. Hi, guys. Boy, am I hungry. I woke up this morning and I thought, gee, I would just love a nice hot bowl of oatmeal in Mr. Hooper's store.
That's a good breakfast. Certainly is.
I know. I figured it this way. Maybe if I start the day with a really good breakfast, then nothing will go wrong. Well, maybe not very much will go wrong.
Right.
David, where's the oatmeal?
Isn't it down there?
No, I don't see any.
I guess we're out.
Didn't you get some more?
I wasn't supposed to get any more.
I told you to get some more.
No, you didn't.
Oh, yes, I did, David.
Well, I don't think so, Mr. Hooper.
I think so, David. Now, I appreciate very much if you do what you're supposed to do, David. Get some more oatmeal.
Wait a minute. I wasn't supposed to get any more because you never said anything about oatmeal to me.
Oh, yes, I did.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Yes, I did, Dad.
No,
I told you to get some more.
They're angry. They're angry, and it's all my fault. Oh, I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry.
Wait, what are you sorry about, Telly?
Well, you two are angry at each other, and it's my fault.
No, your fault? It's not your fault.
Yeah.
No, it isn't. Now, this is between David and me. Now, if David would do what he was supposed to do, we wouldn't be angry now.
Yeah, but it is my fault. If I hadn't wanted oatmeal for breakfast,
Telly,
we wouldn't be angry at each other.
Telly, it's not your fault. Now, eventually, somebody was going to come in here and ask for oatmeal. This is a misunderstanding between Mr. Hooper and me. Right, Mr. Hooper?
Right.
I still can't stop worrying about you.
It's not your fault.
It's not my fault.
No.
You promise?
We promise.
Oh, what a relief.
Oh. Good morning. Oh, I am in such a good mood this morning, and you can't imagine what I'm in the mood to eat.
Oatmeal, I bet.
How did you guess?
Oh, Olivia, whatever happens, it's not your fault.
It's not my fault. What?
And I still say I asked you to get some oatmeal.
And I say that you didn't.
I did.
You didn't.
Do you believe this?
Oh, Greetings. Yes, it is I, the amazing Mumford, and I understand there's a slight altercation going on here between David and Mr. Hooper. Am I correct?
You sure are, Mumford.
Well, perhaps I can be of assistance. With just a wave of my magic wand, I, the amazing Mumford, will end this argument.
Doubt that. Not with somebody as stubborn as he is.
Look who's talking stubborn.
I see I came just in the nick of time. A few magic words will make you forget what you were angry about. You won't remember a thing about it from beginning till now.
You know, Mumford, I don't think you can make anger disappear with magic. People have to talk it through, you know? And then, you know, then they'll make up. People get angry at each other all the time and make up, but without magic.
I've always preferred magic myself. What do you say? Why not give it a try?
Okay.
You won't remember a thing. You'll be just as friendly to each other as you were before you got angry. Ready? Here goes. A la peanut butter sandwiches.
Hello, Olivia. Hello, good morning, Mumford.
Hey, Mumford. Hi, Olivia. You want some breakfast?
Oh, it was. I mean, they're not angry anymore. They don't even remember.
Of course. What are you two talking about? Remember what?
Oh, nothing.
Well, would you like something to eat?
Oh, yes. Come to think of it, I am hungry. I'd like a bowl of steaming hot oatmeal.
Oh! Steaming hot oatmeal.
Hey,
coming
good.
Up.
Sounds good to me.
David, where's the oatmeal? David?
I don't know. Maybe we're out.
Did you get some?
No, I didn't get some. You never asked me to get some.
I told you to get some oatmeal.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
Oh, no, you did?
Oh, I did.
Were you talking to me?
I was talking to Y-O-U.
No.
To me? Yeah, to me.
To me?
Yeah, to me.
Oh, hi, Mr. Duper.
Hoopa, Hoopa.
Hi, David.
Yeah, Javi, bro, how you doing?
Oh, no, are you two still mad at each other?
Well, if David wouldn't do what he's supposed to do, I wouldn't be mad at him.
Yeah, I wouldn't be mad if Mr. Hoopa would stop saying that. He never asked me to get any oatmeal, and I never said I would.
Oh, you should hear yourselves. Why, Oscar would love this.
Yeah, so what's wrong with a little arguing?
Well, you can argue if you want, forever and ever. And you can stay mad at each other and never be friends again, if that's what you want. Is that what you want?
No, that's not what we want.
No. Now, Mr. Looper.
Hooper.
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 When was it that you asked David to get the oatmeal?
Let me think. Oh, yes, I remember. It was yesterday, in the evening, before I closed the store, I was taking stock. Forgetful Jones came in. We said hello to each other, and he asked me what I was doing. I told him, and then said we need more oatmeal, and that I was going to ask David to get some more when he gets back.
Well, you don't need to do that. You don't need to ask him anything. I'm here. I'll be happy to get you farina.
No, not farina. Oatmeal.
Well, that too. Whatever you need, I can get for you.
Well, knowing how forgetful can be, I wrote it down on a piece of paper for him.
Yeah. Well, oh, you need something?
Yeah.
Well, why didn't you say so? I'll be happy to get it for you.
It's written down on the paper here. See? Oatmeal, so you can remember.
Yes, it does say oatmeal. Well, what do you know? How do you like that? Yeah. And now exactly what am I supposed to do with this piece of paper?
Well, you said you would get oatmeal for me, right?
Yeah.
Well, here you are. It's written on a paper, so you'll remember.
Ah, I see now. I see. Yeah, but what do I do with the paper?
Forget it, forgetful. I'll get David to go and get it for me when he comes back.
Well, forget what?
The farina. No. The oatmeal.
Oatmeal? I don't want any oatmeal. I don't even like oatmeal. Well, sorry. Thanks anyway. Oh, whoop. I better be going. It's getting late. See ya.
And then I think you came back for making the deliveries, David. And that's when I asked you to get the oatmeal.
Well, that's that. I'm finished.
Finished? Oh, David,
What's the matter?
David, good night.
Good night, Mr. Hooper.
Good night. Oh, David, I never asked you. I was so confused that I forgot to ask you, really, David. I'm so sorry. I'm very sorry.
It's all right. I'm just glad we got everything cleared up.
Yeah, me too.
And so am I. Well, I think I'll go and get some of them.
No, don't worry. I'll go.
No, David. I'll go.
No, I'll go.
David, I insist that
I
go.
No, I want to go.
David, I'm responsible.
Hey, don't you two ever stop.
Do I look all right, Bird?
Oh, you look...
I want to look my best for your friend.
You look fine. You always look fine.
How about the tie?
That looks good on you. Why, I think you're probably the handsomest Snuffleupagus I've ever seen.
Oh, Bird.
Now, this is our big chance because I've told Maria and Olivia to meet me out front. And I haven't told them why.
Oh,
this way I know they'll be there.
Oh, Bird, you are so smart.
I know. Now, let me check and see if they're coming, okay?
Yeah.
Now, hold on.
Okay.
Oh, they're coming. Okay, come on. Let's go meet them.
Bird, I don't think I can go out there. I'm so nervous.
Oh.
I really want to meet your friends, but I don't think my legs will carry me out there.
Oh, Snuffy. Oh,
couldn't you get them to come in here?
Oh, Snuff. Well.
Oh, please.
Okay,
Bert.
Okay, since you're my best friend.
Oh.
But wait here, will you?
Oh, yes. Oh, thank you, Bert. Oh,
it's okay now. This is our big chance. They'll finally get to meet you.
Yeah.
Oh, Olivia! Maria, come here!
I don't think I like this tie after all. I should have worn another one. Maybe I should go home and put on a different tie. Yes, that won't take long.
Big Bird, you have wanted us to go inside your nest to see the Snuffleupagus 1,000 times, and he's never there. Why should we go now?
Because he's right there now, and he wants you to see his new tie.
Big Bird, you're too much. I can't believe this.
Oh, but he's right there.
Did I hear someone say 1,000 times? What did I miss?
Big Bird wants us to go into his nest and meet Mr. Snuffleupagus again.
Will that make 1,001?
No, because we ain't going.
You mean you aren't going. And you should be going in there right now.
Big Bird, we're not going to go back in there again to meet this imaginary friend. He's never there.
He's not.
I have never met this Mr. Snuffleupagus.
Well, of course you haven't. He's imaginary.
He is not imaginary. Count, would you like to see him?
Well, actually, I'd like to count him. If that's okay.
Sure. But of course, in order to count him, you've got to go in and see him.
Oh, something new to count. I cannot wait.
Oh, at last. At least the count is going in.
That's one. One Snuffleupagus.
See?
What? Where is he? Count, weren't you just... counting, Mr. Snuffleupagus?
Yes, yes, I was. Isn't it wonderful? I can count as many Snuffleupaguses as I can imagine Snuffleupaguses. Oh, that's two Snuffleupaguses. Three Snuffleupaguses. Four.
No,
four
he was here. He was here, five, right here. Snuffy, where did you go?
Well, six.
But
seven.
No.
Eight Snuffleupaguses. Nine Snuffleupaguses. Ten Snuffleupaguses!
Hey!
145 Snuffleupaguses! 146 Snuffleupaguses! 147!
He has some imagination! 8
Snuffleupaguses!
I'll say.
149 Snuffleupaguses! 150
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters L and P and by the number 7. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. Adios!